The purpose of this video is to show you the basics of using a DITA Subject Scheme Map to profile content in Oxygen. A Subject Scheme Map allows you to create and manage custom profiling values in DITA documents, and it uses key definitions to define a collection of attribute values instead of a collection of topics. By defining controlled values and using hierarchical levels in a Subject Scheme Map, you can filter and flag content in author mode or in transformed output. The advantages of using a subject scheme to control profiling attribute values include: first, you can create a hierarchy of profiling attribute values and use a DITAVAL file to filter them. Second, you can share the files with others without having to share preferences or the entire project. And the subject scheme offers validation support so you are notified if an undefined value is used. For the purposes of this demonstration, I will focus on a use case where I want to customize the values of the audience profiling attribute. More specifically, I want the audience attribute to offer values that identify various audience types for a gardening publication. I want my subject scheme to include two categories for the intended audience, expert and novice, and the expert category will have two subcategories, botanist and gardener. This will allow me to profile my content so that the output gets filtered to only include information relevant to each category of user. Now, I'll show you how to create a subject scheme map in Oxygen using a built-in template. I will click the New File button on the toolbar to open the new document wizard. Now I'll search for the subject scheme template. I'll select the template, give it an appropriate name, and click Create. And the subject scheme file is opened in the editor. To define my subject scheme, I can either use the visual controls that you see here in author mode, or I can switch to text mode and define it there. Both methods are pretty fast and simple, so it's just a matter of preference. For this demonstration, I'll use the author mode controls. Notice that the template includes navigation titles. These elements are not required, but you can use them if you want to show an alternate name when selecting attributes values in Oxygen, rather than seeing the actual value. For example, if you want to use an abbreviation or code for defining the value, but you want to show the full name in Oxygen. For my purposes, I'm going to delete those unnecessary elements since I want to use the actual values. Now I'll define the hierarchy for my subject scheme and assign values for the keys. This first value is for the key that represents the whole tree of values, so I'll call it audience key. Now remember the graphic I showed you with the values and structure that I want for my subject scheme. So this next value will be expert. Then I need two subcategories to be botanist and gardener. Now I need to create a new value for the novice category, and I want it to be on the same level in the tree as the expert category. So I'll click the appropriate plus sign, and I'll enter novice for the value. Next, I need to bind my tree of values to the particular attribute. So the attribute is audience, and I want to bind it to the key I used for the whole tree of values. I called it audience key. I'll save the file. Notice that I have a validation error, and that's because I still need to add a reference to my subject scheme in my main DITA map. And I'll do that now. The easiest way to do this is to keep the subject scheme file opened in the editor. Then in the DITA Maps Manager, right-click the main map and select Append Child, then reference to the currently edited file. This opens a dialog box where you can configure the reference however you want, but there is one specific thing that you need to do to define your reference as a subject scheme map for its type. To do this, go to the Attributes tab, and in the Type field, enter or select Subject Scheme. I'm also going to enter a navigation title that will appear in the DITA Maps Manager. Now I'll click Insert and Close. I'll save my map. And that binds my subject scheme to the main map. And now I'll test my subject scheme. I'll right-click one of the topics in my map, go to Edit Properties, and to the Profiling tab. Notice that Oxygen has merged the profiling attributes that I defined in my subject scheme map with the default attributes. These other profiling attributes are not relevant in my case, so ideally it would be nice if they were not displayed at all. So I'll show you how you can use that same subject scheme file to overwrite or filter them out. In the binding section, I click the plus sign to add a new binding. I'll enter one of the attributes I want to filter out. I'll leave the second box blank, and this will instruct Oxygen to reject all possible values for this attribute. I'll then add the other attributes I want to overwrite. Now, after saving the subject scheme file, if I go back to the Profiling tab in the Edit Properties dialog box, you see that only the audience profiling attribute is available along with its values. Now, to illustrate the advantages of using a subject scheme, I'll show you an example of each of them in action. The ability to create a hierarchy of controlled values makes profiling even more efficient. I've created a DITAVAL file that simply filters the expert value from the audience attribute. Now I'll create a condition set called novice only that uses my DITAVAL file. Next, I'll open a topic that has content profiled for both botanist and gardener. Now I want to see what it would look like if I exclude my expert values. So I'll select the condition set I just created. And you see that it filtered out both values that were defined as subcategories for my expert value. The next advantage is that if you want to share your custom profiling values with others, you only need to share the files without having to share all of your preferences or your entire project. The other advantage is validation support. I'll run a validation on my DITA map. And you see that I have a validation error that tells me that I have an undefined profiling value. And I can easily correct this problem by deselecting the wrong value and selecting the correct one. Now I'll run the validation again, and you see that we no longer have the error. For more information on various other DITA profiling possibilities, see the Oxygen User Manual or our other similar videos. This concludes the video demonstration. Thank you for watching.